When you receive inventory in NetSuite, you may want to be able to assign different statuses to the inventory. Let's take a look at what using inventory statuses in NetSuite looks like. Before you can start assigning inventory statuses to your inventory, there are a couple things you need to do. First, you might need to turn on this feature in Enable Features. You can find this feature in the Inventory section of the Items and Inventory tab of Enable Features. If the Inventory Status feature is not available in your account, contact your NetSuite account manager. Once you have enabled the Inventory Status feature, you can create inventory status records. NetSuite automatically creates a default inventory status of good, but to create your own inventory statuses, navigate to Lists, Supply Chain, Inventory Status, New. On this page, you will name your status based on what you wish this status to communicate about your inventory. For example, you might have an available status and an unavailable status, or you may wish to label inventory that you receive in bad condition as damaged. The checkbox Make Inventory Available for Commitment is located directly under the name field, and it is checked by default. When this box is checked for an inventory status, any inventory that is assigned that inventory status will be available for commitment on orders. Conversely, inventory statuses that do not check this box will not be available on orders. When creating an inventory status, you can also provide a translation for the languages that you use in your NetSuite account. After creating all the inventory statuses in NetSuite that you will need, you are ready to start using them. How do you assign inventory statuses to your inventory? On an item receipt record, you would go to the Items section of the Items and Expenses tab. There, select the Inventory Detail field to choose a status. NetSuite will open a small window where you can set the inventory status of this item. If you are receiving multiples of this item, you can also select different inventory statuses for portions of the order. For example, if you receive a large shipment, but half of the order is damaged, in this window you can assign half of these items the inventory status of good and half of these items the inventory status of damaged. At times, you may find that you need to update an item's inventory status. For example, an item that has been marked as available may be damaged in the warehouse and need to be changed to a status like damaged. To change an item status, navigate to Transactions, Inventory, Inventory Status Change. On this page, you will provide the date of the status change, the location where the status change applies, and both the previous and revised status. Then, at the bottom of the page, you will be able to select the items that this change will apply to. You can make this change to many items all at once, as long as the previous and revised status are the same for each item. Suppose you want to see some statistics on your inventory statuses. To do that, you could run an inventory balance search. Navigate to Lists, Search, Saved Searches, New, and select Inventory Balance from the list. In the Criteria section of the new search, you can filter by things like item, inventory number, location, on hand, bin number, and, of course, status. Filtering your search by a specific inventory status will enable you to easily see what inventory is assigned to certain statuses. Once you have used an inventory status, you cannot delete it. So, in the event that you no longer need a certain inventory status in your account, you can inactivate that status. To do that, open the inventory status record and select the inactive checkbox. The ability to use inventory statuses in NetSuite is just another way to ensure that you are managing your inventory well. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, let us know by hitting the like button. And to learn more about how SuiteRep can help you with all of your NetSuite needs, visit us at SuiteRep.com.